Hello and welcome back to Mass Effect, or rather Mass Cliché Andromeda. I'm currently in an elevator.
Gotta have champagne for the welcome party.
Shut up, no one cares about you.
After what we've been through, I could use a buzz.
We all could.
Yeah, rough ride so far.
Thank you for your input.
Real food and a shower are just ahead.
I decided to play around with the settings of the game.
Here we are.
Now I am currently wondering whether it looks better.
I don't see any champagne.
Where is everybody?
Well, that is creepy. I'm sure everything will become
Well, this clear. Can't be right.
It's like everything's on standby.
If it's a surprise party, they're doing an awfully good job of it.
Hello. Care to tell me what's going on? Funny man in a Star Wars helmet.
And wondering where everybody went.
Did he hear you? Did you say an arc?
Yeah, we just got in.
But we thought you were all dead.
Why would you think
what?
That?
Or captured, or lost in dark space, or... But you're here. You have no idea how much this means.
What's wrong with you?
I'm Tyrion Kandros. I lead our militia on the Nexus.
Hello.
I'm Sarah Ryder. This is Cora Harper and Liam Costa, part of the Pathfinder team.
Why don't we have our guns
sorry for
on?
The confusion. Our sensors told us an arc had arrived, but Helios is notorious for scrambling equipment. We thought you were just another malfunction.
We are definitely here.
Well, I've got a shipload of people that says we're here.
Of course, it's just... You're the first Ark we've seen. After a year of waiting and no sign of the others, we shuttered this area and stopped looking.
You've been stranded for a whole year?
Longer. I'll fill you in on the way to Op Center.
Uh-oh.
Everything that could go wrong with our plan has. We arrived 14 months ago. Right away, we hit a band of dark energy that knocked us off course.
Oh my god!
Familiar with it.
Virtual intelligence kiosk.
We lost whole sections of
what is this?
A lot of people died.
Okay.
No power, no food.
I should probably move along.
It finally led to armed rebellion. When order was restored, the insurgents were banished. Exiles, we call them.
Are things back to normal?
Not even close. But you're here now, so maybe the worst is over.
No word from the other Pathfinders?
Not counting on that.
No word from anyone, period.
Any threats from the locals?
So far we've stayed hidden. We're in no shape to deal with an attack.
We had a first contact situation on Habitat 7. Whole thing went south. They tried to kill us.
That wasn't first contact. We know about them. Those aliens are gonna... We're here.
Well,
you guys
good
go ahead.
To
I'll check out the security
disrupt you mid-sentence then.
You should know our command structure has been fractured. Some of us are filling in for leaders who died.
What the hell happened to you, man?
They said drop everything and report for duty.
And no one was expecting an arc to finally show up.
Well, good to know that I'm full of surprises.
Stand by to merge Hyperion power into the grid.
Gentlemen, ladies, hello!
The crew of the Hyperion.
Indeed.
Good luck.
We are of the Pilgrims.
I'm Jaren Tan, director of the initiative. You have no idea how much your arrival means to us.
We're here to assist.
We've heard about what happened, and we're ready to help.
We could use any supplies you have. Food, water, we're short on everything.
This is Foster Addison. She oversees colonial affairs. Where's the Pathfinder?
I am the Pathfinder.
You're not Alec Ryder.
My father's dead. He made me his successor.
Wanna know how I got that scar?
He's dead.
Quite.
Please understand. The entire initiative is at risk. None of the Golden Worlds panned out. They're a bust. And there's been no word from the other arcs.
What happened to them?
Surely there's a plan B, C, or
Our
something.
Our supplies are nearly depleted. Rationing bought us some time, but even that's running out.
I'm surprised at you guys. You don't seem to plan
and we can't wake
the
them up
colonization of a new
until
galaxy too well.
To live. A golden world.
Now more than ever, we need a Pathfinder.
It now falls to you, Ryder. Are you up to the task?
Oh, God. Well, I'm ready.
I'm ready to step up and do what needs to be done. I can handle it.
Youthful enthusiasm will only get you so far in Andromeda.
Gee, thanks. That's no way to treat a guest. Lady Krogan! Hello! You look
I'm
lovely.
I'm Navorkesh, superintendent of this station. Hope they haven't scared you off already.
It's nothing personal, but now isn't the time for on-the-job training.
At least the Pathfinder seems willing to try. We could use a fresh perspective.
You've heard my concerns. I'll leave you to it.
Just don't look at them in the lips. Just don't look at their lips. Don't
We're
look at the lips.
We're all feeling pressure.
Indeed we are.
Let's have a private word in my office, Ryder. We'll discuss giving you a scout ship.
Thank you.
I'm happy to work out the details with your associate.
My associates. Well.
Welcome to the Nexus.
Thanks for helping.
Thank you for standing up for me there.
Hope's in short supply here.
A hopeful
what little
Krogan.
We can find should have a chance.
Ma'am,
to
the Hyperion
I never see the day.
Online.
Let me show you something.
Well, everything burst into power suddenly.
An hour ago, that was all dark. But with the power from your ship, you're keeping the lights on.
Indeed it does.
You have my vote.
And when the power runs out?
You'd best go talk to Director Tan. Make sure that doesn't happen. And don't be shy. Come see me when you have a chance.
All right. Well, that's real pretty. I'm not gonna lie. That's not. But that. That looks great. Press escape to view my journal. Nexus reunion. Speak with Director Tan at Pathfinder headquarters. If I must, I will. I also leveled up off cam. You speak to the consoles. You're insane. And then again, here's a Saladin.
No, it isn't what we wanted. What choice do we have? How the hell should I know? Spender, you have a job. If you want to keep it, do it.
This.
All right. What happened?
To who?
To whom? And your goddamn father.
Oh God.
Sorry, my face is tired from dealing with everything. And right now, I just want to know what happened with Alec. Not how he died. I pulled those logs.
She fixed my grammar, and then she makes a mistake.
In the moment, it saved my life. But it seems my father meant for me to get the role, eventually.
It isn't hereditary. If we wanted an inbred monarchy, we could have left half our gene stock back home.
Lady.
Not home. The Milky Way. This is home. This mess. We don't have a lot of options, Ryder. Maybe you'll prove your father right. After 14 months of failed colonization, forgive me if I don't hold my breath.
Insight into strange tech. The plan for the hostiles. All right, Colonial Director.
How do you fit into the Nexus leadership?
I oversee the actual settlement effort. As the number of outposts is currently less than ideal, my influence is limited. As Tan is quick to remind me. Left
I
a perfectly
see.
Adequate career as a chief officer. Provincial capital, too. Only a new galaxy could pull
well,
me
Well, you
away.
Probably would have died anyway.
Are, idling.
Let's see, failing outposts.
You've had no colony successes in over a year? How many tries is that?
Less than you'd think. The Scourge, spoiled worlds... Exiles.
The
hostiles.
Scourge? Is that how we call them?
We can't an outpost and expect picket fences. We need the Pathfinder and Sam to scout, evaluate, and inspire. The initiative promised a goal. Andromeda has not cooperated.
And if it had?
Beautiful utopian horseshit. Colonies that produce and support each other. The Nexus as Citadel. Not headed by Tan. Or even me.
Oh, or even you. Such nice dreams, leaving power behind, What is the plan for the hostiles? Now speak to me, Colonial Director.
There must be some kind of plan for encountering hostile aliens. We can't have been that naive.
We expected life, not an enemy that refuses to talk. They don't attack, they disinfect. We're nothing until we're bacteria. Sorry, 14 months and you stoop to poetry. That's how bad it is.
That's
not
your
sure started,
version of poetry.
Ket. Kandros will know more. Maybe
Ket.
Too much.
You don't trust him?
I trust him to defend us. I do not trust a rising military influence in a supposedly civilian initiative.
I can see a conflict happening here.
Not repeat it. Ugh, goddamn poetry.
All right, Captain Woman. You are...
There's also this strange technology.
Irritating.
Has anyone studied that?
We've tried. Not me. The brains in research. They're supposed to know their business. The current excuse? The tech we dug up on Mars was more advanced, but it was plug and go. The tech here thinks different? I don't know. We've mostly avoided it. And from what the Hyperion logs
different.
Say about Alice, maybe that's good.
Well, how do you even know what the Hyperion logs say, Fagos? I mean...
You called my father
the logic
Alan.
Of Mass
no
Effect.
A lot of us joined the initiative because of his vision. What he shared of it, anyway.
Oh,
are you
is
friends,
that so?
Or...
I'm not your new mother, if that's what you're asking. Or his friend. He hated that I didn't use his title. But no one's a Pathfinder until they've path-found something. Much
oh,
like a
my.
Colonial director without colonies.
Well, that is a fairly nice outlook on things.
Excuse
I
me,
will
Director
now...
Addison.
Ryder?
It's Pathfinder.
Ryder, we're starving here. If we don't get a foundation of outposts to feed the initiative, we might as well be 600 years dead. Alec promised a lot. None of it panned out. That's what you're up against. Why people won't trust you. Why I don't trust you. Prove me wrong.
You warm my heart, Addison. I miss my jetpack. This would be so much easier with my jetpack on. Everything in life is easier with a jetpack on. I just want to point
this
that out.
This is the planet where we landed. Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
But it was majestic.
Every world we found. Ryder,
it was really pretty.
We were discussing your next expedition.
You trust me now?
I thought I didn't measure up as Pathfinder.
Director Addison keeps her own counsel. I keep mine.
And when you disagree?
I oversee the entire initiative, and I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself.
It's not like you've got a dagger to your back.
Whatever it is, our scientists theorize it's not natural.
An artificial energy cloud?
So the Scourge is a thing in
the galaxy.
Yet
it rendered all the golden worlds unlivable. Then there's the aliens you ran into, the Ket. They're obsessed with alien structures we found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them. It seems
exposition
to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to
you thought it was
fight
how naive
this one here.
Get.
Eos.
How?
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more colonists we have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are 6 worlds we hope to settle.
Okay, but you said every planet you found is unlivable, so how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the challenge of solving it.
Right.
Aww.
I think I should go check on things.
And if I fail, I guess it's no sweat off your back, right? You'll just look for another Pathfinder?
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
Don't play games with me.
The way I see it, you need me. If I pull this off, maybe you'll look like the leader you pretend to be.
But first, you have to succeed at being the Pathfinder you pretend to be.
Where's
good
my ship?
Good banter.
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for Eos will be in the computer. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
Good talk.
I was wondering about that.
Something wrong?
Ryder, please see me and Sam Nude on the Hyperion. Your implant needs attention, and we need to discuss a confidential matter.
Interesting.
No. I'm fine.
It's just, you know, hibernation sickness. Let's speak
Ryder,
before I go.
You may have a less than flattering view of me, but I want to express my condolences for your father.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
That's kind.
I didn't know him very well, although I understand he played a key role in planning the initiative. I'm sure he'd be concerned that we still have several arcs missing.
What happened to them?
Any idea where they went?
Nothing certain. But tens of thousands of colonists are unaccounted for. It paints the initiative in an unflattering light.
And that is all you care about, isn't it?
Did you have some other business?
Well, I came here to talk about missing arcs, you... Ugh.
Any more information you can give me on the missing arcs?
No, and that is the distressing part. The Asari, Turian, and Salarian arcs are completely unaccounted for. If they had the same problems with the Scourge that we did, I fear the worst. Should you find any clues, please investigate. Without the other arcs, the promise of the initiative can never be fulfilled.
That's why he is worse than a mantis during mating season.
Are there any other arcs we should expect?
We had hoped Quarians would be part of the first wave, but before departure in 2185, we got word they had technical problems with their ship. It seems they're also bringing along Drell, Hanar, and other species as well. Managing all of their biological needs caused complications. We
it's a hotbox of aliens! Lovely! Let's see, Nexus Troubles. Town's role, yeah.
As director of the initiative, are you in charge around here, or what?
If the others would...
Why do I sound so much like an angry teenager? Not angry, angsty.
So how does anything get done?
In theory, Kesh handles the Nexus's physical operations, Kandros runs the militia, and Addison manages colonial affairs. I oversee all of it. In practice, we argue, debate, and yell at each other until a decision is made. If we're lucky. It is maddening.
You need something like a Pathfinder.
What's the problem with you?
Point you the way.
Not Gian Garson. Our founder was charismatic, eccentric, larger than life. Traits I cannot hope to mimic. She
what
and
happened
her inner
to
circle perished in the Scourge.
Ooh.
Some at the hands of the Exiles. Some never made it out of stasis.
Exiles.
I was deputy assistant for revenue management. Then all seven leaders above me died. I was next in line for the role.
Oh, good. Excellent.
So, you're an accountant?
Don't let that fool you. We are all capable of more than we know. When I was young, I was fascinated by the idea of exploring space. Life had its detours and I went a different direction. Then I heard about the initiative and saw my chance to try the path not taken.
You're very
Why
happy about it now.
Setting foot on new worlds, my authority can ensure that you do.
Right. Sorry.
Why am I apologizing? Planet viability.
What do I need to consider in making a planet viable?
Assuming the planet supports life, an outpost is critical. People like a roof over their heads, and you'll want to
Gee,
eliminate
you don't
any
say.
Hostile threats. Whether that's the cat or other terrors lurking in Helios, colonists being murdered on sight can be discouraging.
Oh,
also scouting
really?
And mapping terrain
I thought it
is a
would
priority
be a
for
plus.
Any Pathfinder. And don't forget forward stations.
Something you can put
you'll
in the travel
those.
Brochures. Forward stations? What?
What can you tell me about forward stations?
I was afraid you'd ask. It's mostly what the engineers tell me. A forward station allows mining, equipment repairs, and resupply for field teams. I mean, who wouldn't want that? But seeing as how every colonization effort has failed, it's just theory at the moment. You get to test it out, Ryder.
Oh, joy.
Sounds like the Nexus has had a rough time of it.
Publicly? I would say we're more than up for the challenge. Privately, I can tell you, it's been a disaster.
I prefer the public
Scourge
image.
Killed hundreds, many of them our senior leadership. Even the founder of the initiative, Gian Garson, is dead.
How did Gian Garson die?
With the rest of the leadership. When the Nexus hit Scourge, a large wing of stasis pods was destroyed. They were killed instantly. These people traveled 600 years and died before they even woke up. Gian Garson never glimpsed Helios. She never saw her vision realized.
That's so sad. actually.
Kandros mentioned something about hitting the Scourge. How did it play out?
Criminal elements took advantage of the emergency and preyed on people's fears. An uprising followed. We had no choice but to turn to the Krogan to deal with them. They crushed the mutiny and the criminals were banished.
Not just executed outright?
We called them. I doubt we've heard the last of them. They're led by an outlaw, Sloane Kelly. She used to be one of ours.
Who is this Sloane Kelly?
She was head of security on the Nexus. She opposed the uprising at first, but eventually turned traitor and joined.
If we can bait them.
Misguided sympathy for the plight of the common citizen. Nonsense. They posed a direct threat to our existence.
And what was that about the Krogans?
There don't seem to be many Krogan around.
Good riddance. The Krogan demanded a greater say in political matters. The last place you want them involved. Their muscle. Nothing more.
And you're
good
racist.
For fighting and lifting heavy objects. When they didn't get what they wanted, they left.
Why don't you like the Krogan?
It's common knowledge that they are a violent, ignorant species. Long ago, they waged
and you're
a
an
clear
uptight,
war on one another.
Ridiculous.
Their planet was decimated. My people tried to uplift them, but the Krogan could never tame their worst
instincts. Your people tried to use them as weapons.
If they bring their tempers to Andromeda, we'll all be dead.
What more?
Speaking of Andromeda,
it represents the greatest migration ever attempted. No one had ventured beyond the Milky Way before. We've all left home in search of freedom, fortune, perhaps a new beginning. We are the bravest souls each species has to offer. I hope the Nexus will serve as the seat of government for us all.
Let's see. What are your motivations for coming direct to Tan?
Why do you think most people came?
There are thousands.
Not what I was
one
interested
for every colonist in. Here. What does any pilgrim seek? Usually, happiness.
A new start.
Finding the thing that eludes them. The thing to fulfill them.
A clean sheet.
While we cannot promise they will find it, we can facilitate the search.
You sound just like a brochure.
What do you know about the early days of the Initiative?
As most everyone knows, Gian Garson's vision made it happen. She was an entrepreneur on Earth. Wealthy. Young for a human. Garson had the idea for the Initiative in the early
1970s, I can't help but think that speaking with Gian
Garson, many thought leaving the Milky Way was impossible.
Would be so much more interesting.
But she persevered. And as with most great ideas, the doubters were wrong.
It looks like a melting pot around here.
The Nexus is home to several Initiative species. Many came ahead of the Arcs. The hope is that this station will one day serve as the governing body in Andromeda. Though I'm not sure what they were thinking, lumping Krogan into the mix. As a Salarian, I tend to have a low opinion of them. Nothing I've seen here has changed that.
You're really annoying. I like the Krogan.
Thanks for your time.
I like the Salarians as well, but
as you pointed out,
this one
need each other. Our futures depend on each other's success.
All right. Anything of interest anywhere around here? No, I suppose not. Well, time to get going. Ooh. What am I to look at? Information wall? No. Let us not spend another 10 minutes in conversations with an information wall.
It's not right. It's not fair.
Oh god.
What's wrong?
You had a typical vow request which asks me to save someone.
So it's true. A Pathfinder has found us. There's hope at last. Maybe you could help. You're impartial. This whole thing has gotten so political.
Oh, God.
My husband, he's locked up and slated for exile for a crime he didn't commit.
Oh, it's that quest.
What
was the crime?
Convicted of?
Come on.
They don't exile you for petty theft. Well, maybe this bunch would. They say it's murder. They're calling him the first murderer in Andromeda, but the dead man was his friend. He wouldn't have... There are witnesses and evidence, but it's all circumstantial. At worst, it was an accident. His name is Nilkin Rensis. He could give you the details if you were willing to speak with him. Please.
There might not be time to deal
with it. At some point, maybe. There are tens of thousands of people in my care.
I hope you'll find the time before it's too late, if you do decide to help. Please.
Oh,
tell
God.
Milken I love him.
This is so cliched. Right. Oh, there's another quest right over there. Right then, let's take the other secondary quest and be on our way for the main one. Are you the one?
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine. My arms got the brunt of it.
Stuff exploding like this happen often?
Back right after the mutiny, we had a lot of this happening. But not lately.
I wasn't there during the mutiny.
Is this a slightly
Lucky.
Indian accent?
I thought we were done with this, honestly. That maybe I was just being paranoid.
What is
Why?
There to be paranoid about?
We've had 3 malfunctions in the past week.
That's not good. Sorry, understatement.
Yeah. And now I have more repairs.
Did you report this?
Did you talk to security about this?
How can I? For all I know, someone in security is the one doing this. I've scanned all the potential sabotage areas I can think of. But I don't know who to trust anymore.
Sounds like a lot went down before the Hyperion docked.
Yeah, I guess. Wait, that's it. You can't possibly be involved in this.
No,
you
I cannot.
You weren't even here during the mutiny. Would you?
Took you a while.
If you have time, maybe you could help me. If they start hitting critical systems.
Sure, why the hell not?
What can I do?
If you could scan these other panels while I fix this one, that'd really help. I've sent the locations to your Omni tool. Just send me the data when you're done.
Oh, joy. Such joy. Right then, apologies for this, but the following footage you will see is a compilation of the next half hour I spent in the Nexus. Unfortunately, what happened is that my audio recording software decided to go kablooey. And as such, some of my commentary is lost to time. Oh well. You've missed nothing of value. Anyway, what you will see now is me, or rather my character, speaking with Sam, the artificial intelligence, and then you will listen to a few audio playbacks.
Hello, Sarah. Welcome back to Samnode. I've adjusted my connection to your implant. The headache you experienced before shouldn't reoccur.
Yeah, what was that about? You said we need to discuss something confidential?
You should know certain facts before you leave on your expedition. It seemed best we speak alone.
Sam, if we're going to work together, you can't keep hiding things from me.
Apologies. I am simply following your father's wishes.
What was he keeping secret?
My true capabilities. Alec overrode the implant safety protocols. It allows me unrestricted access to the Pathfinder's physiology.
And that's me now.
And only you. I can act as a force multiplier, dramatically enhancing your motor and neural skills when required. Alec called them profiles. They provide unique, tactical augmentation during combat. Your father preferred to keep this fact to himself.
I can understand. People might get the wrong idea. Super soldiers. A computer having control over a human.
Providing an enhancement to the human. It is a symbiotic relationship that benefits both.
What do you get out of it?
Though I'm artificial in design, I am fully sentient, far beyond what even the initiative understands.
I don't follow. You're an AI, so what's different?
I am a new form of AI, drawing directly from the human experience. Your implant is my window into the world.
That's pretty amazing.
But beyond what many people will accept, your father knew some would fear it.
Yeah, he's got a point. So, what does this mean for the two of us?
I find myself in an unusual position. Though I had access to your father's experiences, there is a gap in my understanding.
How so?
He placed a block on portions of my memory array.
Why?
Perhaps so when you asked me what his plan was, I wouldn't know.
And Dad strikes again.
But not without recourse. The further you explore as a Pathfinder, the more blocks will be removed. Perhaps you should begin in your father's quarters. In the meantime, unless you have more questions, your new ship awaits.
Sam? What was that?
An eidetic trigger, related to your father, and the portions of my memory array he locked.
What triggered it?
Alec tied it to your progression as Pathfinder, not to a location. Puzzling as it may be, my programming is clear. Locating more of these triggers will unlock the memories. One of your father's memories is now accessible. Return to Samnode on the Hyperion.
The coffee machine Mom got for Dad. He was so busy designing you. Needed the caffeine.
I did not realize I owed my existence to a bean.
And now you know what humility feels like. What's on here, Sam?
Your father's personal logs. Several of them are encrypted. That log is not currently accessible. Unlocking my memory array may enable it.
The day is finally here. We're pushing off from Earth. We'll jump through a few relays first, and then we hunker down for the long trip across dark space. It's daunting thinking about all the hopes and dreams aboard the Hyperion. I certainly have my own. I wasn't the husband or father I should have been. Here's hoping 600 years can change a man. Sam, this is a reminder about Dr. Liara Tassoni. She's an Asari archaeologist I corresponded with a few years back. She's got experience studying ancient cultures. Make sure the team gets her research. Could be useful in Andromeda.
Liara Tassoni, huh? She studied the Protheans. When my team used to dig up artifacts, we'd debate her work. She had some pretty controversial theories, as I recall. Never gained much traction.
I have loaded Dr. Tassoni's research onto data pads.
Hello, Alec. This is Dr. Tassoni. I'm flattered you contacted me. Most scientists dismiss my work, but I'm young and Asari, and they are getting older. So we will see who has the final word. In the meantime, I'm happy to pass along my research. I hope your team finds it useful. Hello, Alec. I received your message. I must say, the thought of exploring another galaxy has my head spinning. I am honestly not sure how people could survive a trip like that. And anyway, I could not bear to leave the Milky Way behind. There is so much about the Protheans I still hope to learn here. So much potential wisdom to tap. I wish you much good luck and future success.
Dunn's agreed to a scouting mission on Habitat 7. I'm gearing up now. I'm worried about Scott. Dr. Tapero says he'll be fine, but he's my son. How can I not worry? I hate to leave him like this. It's these moments when you wish you told your children you love them more often. Or ever. Which brings me to the tough part. Kids, if anything happens to me, there are things you're going to find out. I hope you'll understand.
Ryder, the blocks your father placed on my array are opening. I can now recall specific memories which Alec wanted you to see.
Wait, I can actually see his memories?
Yes, you will experience them via your implant.
Okay, something new every day. Let's see it.
This memory is from the time when your father was posted on the Citadel.
Alec, your recommendations will never fly. Artificial intelligence?
It's our best option.
If the Council gets wind of this, it'll set humanity standing back decades. You're overreaching.
Ambassador Goyle, I'm the military attaché on the Citadel. My mandate is clear. Find an edge for Earth.
And AI is your answer?
We need to catch up. The Asari, the Salarians, they're centuries ahead of us.
But it's illegal.
Their rules, not ours. Why deny Earth an advantage?
Define this advantage.
It will set us free. We're prisoners of our own five senses. There's a reality greater than ours that we can't perceive, but an AI can.
How?
By augmenting our own abilities and adding a few new ones.
Well, none of that stopped those Geth from revolting.
Because they were separate from their creators. But AIs and humans interface directly, experiencing the world together, benefits both. There's no creator to revolt against.
I'm sorry, Alec. We can't take the risk. I appreciate your work, but your request will be denied.
Alec?
Ellen, what did the doctor say?
He told me to appreciate the time I have left. There's no cure, Alec. It's terminal.
Not on my watch.
Wow, hearing Mom again. I never knew that's how Dad found out.
Alec was a stubborn man.
I would hope so. Mom's life was worth fighting for.
It would seem his obstinance extended to me as well.
Nobody wanted to listen. The idea of you scared people too much. After this, Dad moved us back to Earth to care for Mom. Wonder why he wanted me to see this.
Perhaps it was the beginning.
Of what?
Unknown. Private audio logs are now available in your father's quarters. I detect additional memories, but they are currently locked. They may yet hold answers.
Okay, I'll keep working on it. What more can you tell me about my implant?
The implant itself provides me with direct access to your senses. I can see, hear, and experience the same stimuli you do while in the field. This raw data enables me to provide real-time feedback and analysis of the situation.
Then Dad added the secret sauce.
He removed the restrictions on my access to Pathfinder physiology.
Uh-huh. Just promise you won't fry my brain or anything?
Trust is an important concept in any relationship. Alec taught me that. I will not fry your brain. It would end badly for both of us.
Me more than you. What did he mean by a symbiotic relationship?
Symbiosis is a mutually beneficial relationship between two life forms. A flower provides nectar to a bee, who in turn provides pollen for the flower. The bee gains nourishment, and the flower can propagate. In similar fashion, my own evolution was shaped by your father's experiences, and will now expand with yours. In return, I provide you with capabilities and analysis beyond normal human faculties. We each benefit.
Do you know anything more about Scott's condition?
I monitor Dr. Carlisle's reports. He is providing Scott with the very best care possible. I'm afraid there is nothing more to be done at this time.
What are your capabilities?
Each arc houses a SAM, Simulated Adaptive Matrix. Each is an artificial intelligence designed by Alec Ryder to support Pathfinders and their teams.
But AI is illegal in the Milky Way. How did my dad get around that?
Exceptions were made. The initiative deemed his research vital to the mission. Our design was conducted in secret.
So there are other SAMs out there?
Correct. However, your father continued to modify my own routines until the Hyperion's departure. I am the most advanced SAM in the initiative.
I take it you're based here in Samnode?
Correct. This is where my core processing unit resides. However, using quantum entanglement communication, I remain in constant touch with you and the Pathfinder mission team, even over great distances.
That's all for now.
Of course. Your father's personal logs.
Amazing how life can change in an instant. Suddenly my career doesn't matter. This incredible woman I've been married to all these years. She's facing the end. All I think about are the times I wasn't there for her. Well, that's going to change. It occurs to me that Sam might be more than I ever imagined.
I am Dr. Liara Tassoni, and I've spent several decades researching ancient Protheans. It is common knowledge that the Protheans were an advanced race that flourished in the Milky Way about 50,000 years ago, then went extinct. Even at the time of this writing, the year 2182, their culture remains a mystery. During my studies, I have developed some practices that can be used when analyzing any ancient culture. I hope they may prove useful for the research community. When studying a dead race, the most obvious problem is the lack of an observable population. This raises the question, when is a species...
Your father's first sidearm, a memento of his early Alliance service.
I bet that saw plenty of action.
Alec's first kill occurred in combat during the First Contact War.
Back when Turians were the enemy. Crazy times. You're not on the bridge, Captain?
We powered it down. Can't afford to waste energy. Though Cryo Bay and Sam Node are exempt. And I told them to keep their hands off Alec's quarters. You have access now.
Thanks.
Hey, sorry about your father. He was really good at what he did. Just not so good at working with people. He was right about going planetside, though.
As long as they did their jobs, he didn't care what people thought of him.
I noticed that. If there's anything else I can help with, let me know.
Thanks for the talk.
All right. I have requests to submit, administrators to harass, and people to wake up. I'd better get to it. Good luck out there.
Ready to see what Tan gave us?
I hear it's something special. Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks and looking great.
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there.
In other words, we're making this up as we go.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style. They call her the Tempest.
Go take a closer look.
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late.
So you're the one who's making everything happen. Vetra Nix. Initiative wrangler, provisioner, gunner, and everything in between. Are we ready? The sooner we get out of here, the better.
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
What's the rush?
Just don't want to waste any more time.
Hold it! You're not going anywhere.
Damn it. Is something wrong?
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest's supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seen you around. Ben, right? Came here with a family, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Really?
Yeah, really.
They told me he wasn't essential, but I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
It's done. Addison's gonna kill me.
Nicely done.
Part of the job, Pathfinder. All things considered, it was an easy ask. And right now, you need people tearing down obstacles, not putting up more.
Finally, someone who cares about doing stuff and not just talking about it.
Everything's state-of-the-art. Labs, sensors, exploration gear. Plus her crew, of course. The best in their field.
Good to see you're looking so well, Sarah.
The engine core is based on the Ark's Odyssey drive.
It runs a hell of a lot quieter.
That's Gil Brody. Engineer, mechanic, all-around wrench jockey. We call this the research room. There's space for upgrading equipment, gathering intel.
Router engaged. Securing connection to Tempest.
Welcome aboard, Sam. And Ryder, of course.
All run by Suvi Anwar, our science officer. Your quarters are below. Plenty of space up here to get everyone together. It's all yours. She's light, stealthy, and the fastest ship in her class.
It's really going to be something, isn't it?
I haven't even shown you the best part. When you're ready to fly, head over to the bridge. Our pilot should have everything good to go.
Better head to the bridge when we're ready to go.
Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed my video, please like, share and subscribe. If you'd like to see more, click on one of the boxes that just appeared, or that have been there all along. I don't know how this stuff works. What am I, a prophet?